Navilas Micropulse Yellow Laser, 577 nanometers for the treatment of retinal, vascular, and hematologic diseases. We have a machine equipped with a different system than the traditional one we are used to. This machine needs the acquisition of a high-definition photo. Of the patient's retina. So the patient sits in front of this non-contact machine, so you don't put a lens on the eye, but the machine acquires the patient's photo without having to touch them through this optical system. Having acquired the photo is in the database. We choose the photo that we like best. After choosing the photo of the treatment, this is a central serous choroiditis or chronic central serous choroidopathy. You choose this small edit plan button where we have the option to build the treatment because the treatment has to be carefully constructed before it is performed. Usually with other lasers, we directly perform the treatment on the retina, whereas with this type of laser, we have to plan it beforehand. So photo first, then having acquired the photo, we edit our treatment. We choose the type of treatment we want to do, then the pattern size, which at most goes up to 5. The space between each spot must be 0. This is in common with other lasers too. The sizing of the spot, 200 microns, the power. (300 millivatts), then again the spot size, again it has to be chosen, and the pulse duration, 200 milliseconds. These are the parameters after which we start to draw on the retina the area we are going to treat with. This system. We treat both the foveal area, the fuzz, and we extend the treatment just outside the edematous area. This machine also has available 2 no treatment areas where the machine does not deal with and the surgeon chooses to activate it or not. After finishing the planning, we move on to the execution of the treatment. The patient sits in front of the machine, the laser recognizes the patient and basically overlays the image that we have acquired with the real image. At this point, automatically, with an active eye tracking system that essentially tracks the eye if it moves, it performs the laser treatment. At the end of the laser treatment, a picture can be taken to verify that a proper job has been done. This is the work that has actually been done. And this is the photo that is taken at the end to verify that no damage was done. There are, in fact, no spots on the retina, so no damage was done, being an obvious sub-threshold treatment. So we have the hypothesis that we have made now, for example, the hypothesis of the actual treatment that was performed to this patient, and then the photo of the just treated eye as medical legal evidence that no damage was done to any retinal tissue. You can also use this machine for a laser treatment of the diabetic in the sense of a traditional laser treatment. The patterns, of course, are different. You have to choose a different spot spacing, so a treatment closer to a traditional treatment.